Thank you for tuning into my channel. I will be sharing podcasts on a regular basis that will let you experience the Feldenkrais method via awareness through movement lessons. In the lessons, I will talk you through all the steps. You listen and do at the same time. The lessons are designed to improve ability and reduce effort in movement. The speed of an exercise should always be adjusted to your breathing rhythm. For the lesson, always find a place where you can lie down comfortably and wear clothing that doesn't interfere with your movements and breathing. Also, take a rest whenever you want to. There will be plenty of rests in the lessons, but if you need more, please do. The lessons have been recorded live while teaching a class. If you want, you can all lie down already. Yeah, it's good if you can lie on your back and you have a bit of space for your feet to move around. So if you're lying on the floor, it's nice when you can stretch your legs to the away from your body, but also a little bit to the left and the right. And notice, if you're lying, just notice how you feel, actually. Like, what kind of day did you have? And how is it to lie on the floor now? So lying on your back, and just sense yourself and compare the two sides, your left and your right side, and how similar or different are they? Like, compare your two feet, your lower legs, your left and your right upper leg, the left side of the pelvis and the right side, the right side of your ribs and the left side, your right shoulder blade compared to your left, your right arm compared to your left arm, the right side of your whole back and the left side of your whole back. And do you like some places more than other places or parts? And do you like the differences or the similarities? Or do you like totally something else? And is one foot clearer than the other one if you're lying here? And I sense your legs. And do you have any sense if one leg is better organized than the other one? Like, better organized for standing, I mean. Maybe to figure that out is like, with which leg would you kick a ball? Then that's probably not your standing leg. And then if I tell you this, can you sense that the other leg, so the leg that you would probably stand on, is better organized for standing? Or is that just a really weird question I'm asking, which is definitely true? Now sense your toes. And can you do that without moving them? If you need to move your toes to sense them better, first move them on one foot and then move them on the other foot. Don't move them both at the same time, like both feet at the same time, because then you probably don't notice any difference. Now bend your knees and stand your feet. And feel both of your feet and notice where the weight is. And where is the contact with the floor? Is one foot the same than the other foot? Or are they very different? So where is the weight in the foot? And where does it contact the floor? And notice if that's the same for both feet. And could you imagine lifting the pelvis on the side of the leg that you would not kick the ball with, lying like this? You don't do it, but imagine doing it. And then bring it back to the floor again. And now imagine lifting the other side of the pelvis and bringing it back to the floor again. Is one side clearer in your imagination of how to lift the pelvis off the floor a little bit? Or are they quite the same? Or are they both very unclear? Now imagine the sole of your right foot is a paintbrush. And you slowly start to paint a line with the sole of your foot, sliding the foot away from your pelvis and then back again to the beginning position. And repeat this various times. So the sole of your right foot is a paintbrush and you slowly paint the floor and you paint a line with the sole of the foot, sliding the foot away from you and back towards you again. The whole sole of the foot stays on the floor. So you go as far as when you notice, oh, now the foot starts to kind of come off, then you just come back. And notice, is one direction easier than the other direction? And as you go slow, can you find something you haven't noticed before? Leave it, but keep your feet standing. And now slowly start to slide your foot away again and bring it back and paint the floor. But also try to feel the textures under your foot. Or the temperature of the floor. Is it the same everywhere? Is it hard or soft, cold, warm, bubbly, slippery, carpet? Leave it and keep your feet standing. Now lengthen your left leg on the floor. And start painting. So you just lengthen the left leg on the floor. So it's just lying there, resting. And again, you start to paint the floor with the right sole of the foot. And again, away from your pelvis and towards your pelvis. Really slowly and easy. And notice, is it different when you have your left leg long? Is it easier, harder? Where is it different? Is it different in the leg or maybe in the pelvis or maybe higher up, like your spine maybe? Leave it and slowly roll to your front. And now lying on your front, bend both knees so the soles of the feet are towards the ceiling. And now just bring the left foot towards your bottom and back again. Just easy, and then do it with the right foot. And notice, are they different? Leave it. Roll to your back again and just rest in lying. What do you notice from doing those movements so far? How is your left side compared to your right side? Which parts of yourself do you enjoy? Bend both knees again and stand your feet. And now explore the floor or paint a line with the floor on the floor with your right foot sole, going from left to right. But your knee stays toward the ceiling. So it might be a small movement. So you move it instead of away from you and towards you, you move your right foot a little bit to the left and a little bit to the right. And again, you still have the whole sole of the foot on the floor, so it doesn't need to be a big movement. Can you feel the floor as you do this? And now continue sliding the right foot to the left and the right, but lengthen the left leg and rest it on the floor. And notice if it's any difference if you have the left leg lengthened lying on the floor than when you have your both knees bent. Moving your foot to the right and the left with your knees still towards the ceiling. Where do you move? Now keep doing it, but stand the left leg again. And notice, is this different? Is it clearer now that it's different, or is there no difference? And if it's different, can you feel where? Leave it. Roll to your belly again. Bend both knees and have your feet toward the ceiling again. And now move your right heel to your buttock a few times. And how does it feel now? And now do the same with the left heel. Move that to your bottom a few times. And how does that feel? How do they compare, the right one and the left one now? And also, how do they compare to when you did it the last time? Something change? Leave it. Slowly come back to your back and rest. Now bend your knees and stand your both feet. And start to slide the left foot away from you and back. Again, painting a line on the floor And while you're painting this line, what color is the line that you're painting? And what is the texture under your feet? And the temperature? Is it different sliding this foot along the floor than when you were sliding the right foot? Pause and rest your feet in standing. Now lengthen the right leg. And again, start painting the floor with your left foot away from your bottom and back again. Is this different than when you were painting the floor with both knees bent? And can you feel more of your foot when you move away from your bottom, or when you come back towards your bottom? Keep painting the floor with your left foot and stand the right leg again. And notice, is it easier or different when you have your both knees bent? Leave it. Roll to your front again slowly. Bend your knees, have your feet to the ceiling, or the soles of your feet to the ceiling. Bring your left heel a little bit closer to the bottom and away a few times. And then do it with the right heel. And how does it feel now? Pause on your belly. And now move your right foot a little bit further to the right, towards the floor, and come back. And repeat this a few times. What is this like? Now leave that and move the left foot more to the left towards the floor a few times. And notice what that's like. Leave it. And slowly come back to your back and rest. And lying on your back, what do you sense now? What do you feel? Bend your knees and stand your feet again. And now start to move the left foot on the floor a little to the left and a little to the right. And again, the whole sole of the foot is on the floor and the knee stays towards the ceiling. And it doesn't need to be a big movement, as long as it's comfortable and easy. So you don't have to make the biggest movement, but just a movement that's comfortable, easy, and where the whole sole of the foot stays on the floor and the knee towards the ceiling. And now sense the floor with your foot. Keep going to the left and the right with the left foot and lengthen the right leg and just leave it there. Is it different than when you have both legs bent? And which part of the foot senses what and when? And does it change how you move your feet across the floor when I ask you to pay attention to certain things? Leave it. Slowly roll to your front. Again, bend your knees and have the soles of your feet to the ceiling. And now move your left foot a little bit to the left and back. And then your right foot a little bit to the right and back. And now move your right heel to your pelvis, or to your buttocks, sorry, and back. And your left foot to your buttocks, and your right foot. And what does it feel like? Leave it, roll back to your back and rest. Bend both knees and stand both feet. And now with your right foot, start to make a circle on the floor. Paint a circle on the floor with your right sole of your foot. And your knee still stays towards the ceiling. So your right foot starts to make a circle on the floor. You're painting the floor with the sole of your right foot. And which part of your foot can you feel when you slide your foot in a circle? Now lengthen your left leg as you keep making a circle. And notice, is it different with a long left leg? Leave it. Bring both your knees back to bending and your feet standing. And now start to make a circle with your right foot in the other direction. And notice which direction was easier. Was it the first direction you chose? Or this one? And which parts of the floor do you feel in the circle? And which parts of your feet do you feel in which part of the circle? One more time, lengthen the left leg as you make a circle in this direction. And notice if anything changes. Leave it. Lengthen both legs and rest. And notice how you're resting. How does your right side compare to your left side now? And how do you like lying on the floor? Bend your knees again and stand your feet. And now start to circle the left foot on the floor. And start to paint a circle with your left sole of the foot. It can be a small movement, small. And notice, are you really making a circle with your foot? Or is it more of an egg? How could you make it more of a circle? Is it easier to make a circle with this foot or harder? And how much of the floor do you feel? How much of the floor of the circle and when? And what part of your foot do you feel? At which part of the circle? Lengthen your right leg on the floor. And now make a few circles in the same direction. And now start to make a circle in the other direction with your leg still long. And notice what it's like to circle in this direction. Leave it, lengthen your legs, and slowly roll to your front again. Bend your knees, have your feet toward the ceiling, and bring your right leg to your bottom a few times, and then bring your left leg to your bottom a few times, your left foot, sorry, and now move your left foot out to the left and back, and move your right foot out to the right and back. And do you notice that the movements are maybe pulling through you further, like going higher up in your back, or maybe all the way up to your head, your neck? Leave it, roll onto your back and rest. Bend both knees and stand your feet. Now put your legs together so they touch at the knees and the ankles. And start to circle your feet on the floor. So both your feet and your ankles and your knees stay together. And the knees somehow stay in the middle as well. And go slow so you can feel the feet on the floor. And the whole sole of the foot stays on the floor. So maybe it's a small circle. Now change the direction of the circle. And notice, is it different? Doing it one direction, then the other direction. And what is different? Is there a difference in your legs or your feet or your pelvis? Maybe your hip joints? your back.
Leave it and rest.
Roll to your front again. Bend your knees. And also now here, tie your knees together and your ankles. And now circle your feet in the air. How does it move your pelvis and your spine as you circle your feet in the air like this? Now circle in the other direction a few times. And notice, are you still feeling that something might be happening in your pelvis or in your spine? Is it the same for both directions? Leave it and rest on your front. Bend your knees again on your front and tie the knees together and the ankles. Oh, no, you just tie the knees together this time, sorry. And keep your left leg still and just circle the right leg. How would you do that? So the left leg stays still with the sole of the foot towards the ceiling and circle the right leg in the air. And I circle it in the other direction a few times. Which direction is easier? Leave it, keep your knees bent and tied at the knees. And I start to circle the left foot in the air. And notice what this is like. Make some circles in the other direction. Leave it. And roll onto your back and rest. Bend your knees and stand your feet. Tie the legs together at the knees and the ankles. And again, circle the floor with both feet. Did it get easier? Now make some circles in the other direction. And leave it and just rest on your back. Roll to your front again. Bend both your knees, and this time have them comfortably wide apart. And now start to circle both feet in the same direction. Do you feel that your pelvis is lifting off the floor at a certain point in the circle? Now make some circles in the other direction.
and notice. Is this direction the same as doing it in the other direction? Leave it and rest on your front. Now bend your knees again and move your left heel towards your bottom and back a few times. And then do the same with the right foot, bring it towards the bottom a few times. And now move your right foot a little bit to the right and back. And then bring the left foot a little bit to the left and back. And notice what it feels like. Leave it. And roll to your back and rest. Now bend both knees and stand both feet. And with your right foot, start to paint the floor as in the beginning. So you slide your right foot away from you and back again. And the whole sole of the foot stays on the floor. And how do you do this now? And can you feel more? Is your foot feeling more? Do you feel your foot more? Do you feel the floor better? Do you feel more of yourself involved in the movement? Now switch and do it a few times with the left foot and notice what stands out. Again, ask yourself, do you feel more? Which parts of your feet are clear? Do you feel more of yourself involved making the movement? Or something else that's really standing out to you? Pause and keep your knees bent and your feet standing. And now just a few times, slide your left foot to the left and the right. And notice how you do this now. Is it more easy to keep your knee in the middle? How much of the floor can you feel? How much of your foot can you feel when? Leave it and slide the right foot a few times to the left and the right. And notice how you do that. And what stands out here? Is the touch of your foot to the floor clearer? Do you feel your foot more clear? Maybe you feel more what's happening in your hip joint, with your pelvis. And next time you come to an edge of left or right, start to circle that foot. And notice if this changed. Just circle the right foot on the floor. Now make some circles in the other direction. And pause with your knees bent. And just circle your left foot a few times and notice how you do that. What's that like now? Can your foot know the floor a little bit more easy now? Make some circles in the other direction. leave it, lengthen your legs, and just rest and sense yourself. Again, compare the two sides of yourself. Your right foot compared to your left. Your right leg compared to your left leg. The right side of your pelvis compared to the left side of your pelvis. The right side of your back compared to the left side of your back. Your right arm compared to your left arm. Right shoulder blade compared to left shoulder blade. And even the right side of your head compared to the left side of your head. Can you sense your toes? And did this change? Now roll to your side and come from sitting to standing. And just notice yourself in standing. Take your time to get up, you don't have to rush. But if you stand, just sense yourself. And what is your sense of how you are supported right now? So in standing, what is your sense of how you are supported right now? And then slowly start to walk and notice what you notice as you walk. Are some places a little bit more awake than before? Maybe your hips or your feet, or maybe your neck or your chest. Thank you.